Welcome to Kenya's Real Estate Show. In this show, we'll be discussing everything that affects the real estate market. I know for Kenyans, we have really been active in this market, but at times we still have questions that sit at the back of our minds, even if we have bought plots and we have bought houses, but there's still some questions. This is where you'll get them answered. I am Lucy Kamau. The third characteristic of real estate that you have to be wary about is something we call heterogeneity. Basically, what this means is there is no unit of real estate that is similar to another. Even when you are in the same apartment block, there is someone on the ground floor, one will be on the right, the other one will be on the left, the other one will be a level higher or something like that. When you have a subdivision plan, yeah, it's the same parcel of land that has been subdivided into many smaller plans. You'll always get the people who get the corner property, the people who will get the properties that are facing the road, the people who will get properties that have an opportunity to change use to commercial, and the rest of you possibly have to stay in residential. This is something that you always have to be aware of. So when you're comparing real estate, like for like, I mean, it's something that you may not be able to achieve. So what you need to do in this case is be very clear about what you're looking for when you're coming into the real estate space. If you're purchasing for your own occupation, then what are your preferences? What's your taste like? It will never be the same as anyone else, but it actually guides you in terms of what you will pick when you're faced with all this. It's something that people will usually not realize, and at times people are coming to complain that this person has more space than me, but actually that's what the person on the ground floor gets. Yeah? So if you want to be that person with a space behind the apartment block where you can do one, two, three things, then always know that you're going for a ground floor space. It all depends on individual tastes and preferences. This characteristic of real estate, known as heterogeneity, is also the reason why you will find financial institutions and various investors in this space will always insist on having a professional valuer when they're trying to determine the value of the property. The fact that there's no property alike with another, it means that you're never comparing like for like. Therefore, there are certain aspects that need to be taken into consideration when you're trying to arrive at the value. So please, when you're trying to do a valuation for a property, always consult a property valuer to assist you with this. The fourth characteristic of real estate is durability. Real estate is durable. What we mean by this is that when we put up buildings, usually we say that buildings will last approximately 80 years. But actually what we have seen is that there are certain buildings in Nairobi that have been there for, they've been there for a century. It's actually taking the government intervention to actually ask these people to redevelop their properties at the expiry of their 99-year leases. But generally the point here is that those buildings have been standing for a century. Now, what this means is, if you're actually either buying or building a house for your own occupation, you need to remember that within this span, you have to continually invest in the property. Be prepared for repairs and maintenance, be prepared for wear and tear. These things will actually happen, and you just need to be prepared for it. Unlike putting the same money in, say, the stock market or government securities, you don't need to keep reinvesting in the same security. But in real estate, it's the same unit that you have purchased or built, but you have to be prepared to continue reinvesting in it if you actually want to preserve the value. There's actually the idea that you can neglect it, but what that will do is that the value will deteriorate, and hence your capital appreciation. But unless the land is appreciating, then your building is actually deteriorating. The other aspect on this is that land is indestructible. And this is something that I often find people getting caught up, especially when they're trying to insure. Land is indestructible, therefore you don't need to insure it. Because even if you're insuring against the fire would raise down the building, but the land is not affected. So when you're looking for insurance for your house, kindly exclude the value of the land, because you will just be over-insuring, and there's no insurance company who will ever compensate you for that you've been insuring for the land. Yeah? So land is indestructible, no need to insure it. However, if you're in apartment blocks where you many of you, then in that case, that's a different consideration, which we'll be covering in an episode in the future, but not for now. But yes, just know that if you have a standalone unit, you don't need to insure the land. But if you are in an apartment block, you will need to insure the full value of your property. The other aspect in durability is, you need to know that it's very difficult to change what you have already done. And this is where we are continually calling on developers that before you put up the building, kindly consult with people like property managers who have been handling buildings in their lifetime, so that you factor in enough, you factor in those things that affect a building in its lifetime. Because when you build it, you're not about to change it. And then if you have built something for a specific use, it'll kind of be a determining factor for a very long period of time. Something I can point out in this is that we have seen people who put up cinemas in town. What happened when people no longer really demanded going for cinemas? These people needed to understand, how do we change the building? And all these buildings are then confined to very specific uses, which will take up auditorium style in terms of their use. So mainly churches and possibly theaters or that kind of a thing. But again, it's very limiting. So you have to be very careful. When you're designing something, be ready to live with it for close to a century. Another interesting characteristic of real estate investment is that it gives you both an investment good and a consumption good. What we mean in this is that it's possible for you to live in the house as the house is also appreciating in value. Hence, you're consuming it in terms of housing, and you're also having capital appreciation in terms of an investment.
We're sorry, the number you have dialed is not in service at this time.